one of our NASA buoys out here on Lake Tahoe, and we're out about 2 miles offshore, and these buoys are calibrating satellites that fly around the Earth and measure the Earth's surface temperature. So right now, Katie's up there. She's going to be checking lights to make sure the buoy's safe, and then she'll also be doing some quick calibrations on the anemometers that measure the wind speed out here on the lake. We've had these buoys out for about 15 years now, and it's part of a whole climate measurement process that NASA JPL has been using to monitor the Earth's surface temperatures and how they're changing. And one of the things that people have seen a lot of are pictures of El Nino, where the warm water tongue is coming across the Pacific. And those measurements are taken by the satellites that are being calibrated here at Lake Tahoe. So what Katie's looking at now are some temperature monitors for the lake surface temperature. It's measured about 4 different ways out here on the buoy very, very accurately. Those are basic temperature loggers, and then there's also some instruments on here that use basically a radiometer that measures the infrared heat coming off the surface of the lake. And that's the exact same way that the satellites measure the lake's temperature when they come by. Part of the reason that UC Davis is so fortunate to have this collaboration with NASA JPL is that Tahoe is a really unique environment. So these buoys, there's 4 of them out here on the lake, and part of the reason Tahoe was chosen is that Tahoe doesn't freeze. So even though we have big winters up here at Lake Tahoe, the lake never freezes over. So we get measurements of water from space every time the satellites fly by. Also, the Tahoe, on a day like this, we have very little cloud cover. We have about 300 days a year where there isn't cloud cover over the top of the lake, so when the satellites fly by, they can actually take a reading of the lake surface temperature. Another reason that Tahoe was selected is that it's at a very high elevation. We're at 6,200 feet here, so the satellites have to shoot their signal through less atmosphere, so there's less distortion from the Earth's atmosphere when they're measuring the surface of Lake Tahoe. It provides for a very accurate reading, and that's then being calibrated by this buoy.